Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Coming up this week, we have another Falcon 9 mission expected to lift off. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Nilesat 1 launch is scheduled for Wednesday 8th at 9:04pm UTC or 5:04pm EDT. Then, just a few days later, will be another mission to the ISS with a cargo resupply. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the launch of CRS-25 is scheduled to lift off on Friday 10th at 3:22pm UTC or 11:22am EDT. There was a tweet from NASA Contracts saying, Kennedy Space Center has a special notice regarding notice of intent to issue a sole source modification NASA Commercial Crew Space Transportation Services. It contains images of the contract modification which contain information about increasing SpaceX's additional Crew Dragon flights from 3 to 5. Musk posted a tweet saying 4 Falcon Heavy flights later this year by an incredible team at SpaceX. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the Orbital launch site. Work continues on the Orbital launch mount. The booster quick disconnect hood extension was moved back to the production site. A bunch of tankers were seen delivering propellant to the Orbital tank farm. There was a tweet posted saying on Wednesday, June 1st, 2022, Cameron County Sheriff deputies responded to the SpaceX Stargate facility located at 1 Rocket Road, Brownsville, Texas, in reference to a trespasser. Last video, we found out about the slight delay of the environmental assessment to June 13th. Zach Golden posted a tweet saying, Hey, Starship addicts, it appears that Section 4F of the Starbase Environmental Assessment is now complete. I believe this is the last remaining item to be checked off. We are almost there. There was a tweet posted saying, Just a reminder that the Starship spacecraft has not had a single test flight since May 2021 over a year ago. SM-15 was the last Starship tested. The FAA programmatic assessment does not restrict Starship test flights. Only the Super Heavy is restricted from launches. Eric Ralph captioned it and said, Except SpaceX's suborbital Starship launch license expired a few days ago. Further, Raptor 2 engines were spotted delivered to Starbase. Here's a view of the new E-Dome test tank being built inside the high bay. SpaceX have done a whole heap of Raptor engine testing at McGregor recently and Michael Baylor posted this tweet. He said, 8 engine tests today ties the record for the most we have observed in a single day at McGregor. There was an interesting tweet posted that I want to share. It says, April 2009, Michael S. Malone revealed while interviewing Elon Musk that the two had a bet that SpaceX would put a man on Mars by 2020 or 2025. Musk has continued to reiterate this rough time frame since. This countdown clock expires on 1st of January 2026. No pressure. Musk responded with, it should be possible. During the past week, crews worked to prepare Ship 24 for testing. At some point in the last week, Ship 24 also performed some full cryogenic proof testing. As Ship 24 did some cryogenic proof testing over the last week, there were a bunch of tweets about it. Musk responded to one at some point and posted a tweet saying cryogenic proof test passed. A quick disconnect adapter was installed onto Ship 24. Cosmic Perspective posted a tweet with a picture of Starship 24 having arrived at the suborbital launch site. Felix posted a tweet saying and Ship 24 has arrived at Pad A. Next up, thrust simulator test. Looking at the upcoming road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are some dates for this coming week. There is a possible closure for tomorrow, Monday 6th, as well as Tuesday 7th and Wednesday 8th. Starship 24 has now been lifted onto the suborbital Pad A launch mount. Crews continue to work on the Ship 25 nose cone with it now outside. Sections for the Starship 25 prototype are waiting outside the high bay. Super Heavy Booster 7 was spotted having a grid fin installed in the mega bay. Super Heavy Booster 8 was seen being stacked inside the high bay. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Cansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA SpaceFlight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.